some damn way and you new to some shit. You understand what I'm saying? Yeah, I'm not in the way. I'm not in the way, but in the other way, I'm also saying that also too, I'm Oshun.
But I'm saying to you,
mm-hmm.
they have personalities.
I know they have personalities. Yeah. Right. Right. I understand that, and I know what you're saying, and I'm not really saying no disrespect, because we're talking about a whole other concept. Huh? No. I'm telling you. I'm telling you. See, it's on another concept on what I'm dealing with. I'm telling you that, listen, I know for a fact you dealing with these outside of yourself, it's a different thing. I wouldn't say that based on the what you call it. I wouldn't say that based on I wouldn't say that based on you dealing with a certain amount of things. And I would say that there should be a certain amount of humility. But what I'm saying is, I'm telling you how they come to me, and I'm telling you how they dealt with me, and they told me what to do. I'm telling you what Oshun, I'm telling you what they come to me and tell me what to do. I'm saying, I ain't nobody been more humble than me. My God, you talk about humility. My God, I've given up my whole life for it, but I'm telling you, at a certain level, they told me, look, man, you either with us and be one of us, or whatever the whole deal is. That's what they told me.
I know what you're saying.
Right. That's right. No, I'm not saying that. No, let me make it clear. I'm telling you, this is how I deal with them. Let me make this clear to you how I deal with them. I have said this several times. I deal with them the same way I deal with my family members. You understand where I'm coming from? So that's the way I deal with them. I don't deal with them as any type of entity above me or outside of me. You see what I'm saying? Outside of me. Because I'm going to tell you the truth, my spirit is just as old as theirs. That's just the way it is. You see what I'm saying? It's just as old as theirs. You see? So I'm not telling you to what you call it. I'm telling you basically what they told me they wanted me to deal with them on the level. And you have to get to that level because they was through with me on the other realm. Through with me. I can get none of that stuff to work no more. They say, it ain't about that. And once you attain a certain amount of gnosis, you are one with those gods. You see, you are one with those type of gods. So therefore, I cannot be apart from them because I am them because we are as, you see what I'm saying? Like that also. So that's what I'm saying. I'm talking about trying to get to a certain level of God. See, you think like a God, that's one thing. Think like a human is a whole other thing. And all the type of things. So late in the game is a form of thinking like gods. Now, I say this thing too. You got people that's been over there and it's been a religion for hundreds of years now. That's because they lost the gnosis that at one time it was a system to raise up to the Godhead. You see, to raise up to the Godhead. And that's what I'm talking about. You know, because there is no such thing. Because my thing is I am the Great Mother. You see the concept I'm talking about? When you're talking about chaos is when you're dealing with chaos, there cannot be no separation because there cannot be a definition. We talk in defining terms to define the indefinable. To define the indefinable. And I understand this stuff, what you're saying about the respect on the what you call it type thing. But take for instance and all, where you, in naturalist, case in point. Doing what I do, like I gave a brother, told a brother to do a Vodun ritual, and the brother wasn't right, so they came to him and whipped up on his behind because the brother was, you know, I believe the brother was an agent too, so for a whole week they made him go crazy. This is indefinable, but no way is nothing in this picture separate from the other thing. And to deal with something outside of your own self is to deal with a God inferior than your own self. That's the first thing in the doggone message to the black man. And I understand the humility part based on ego. And I think it's kind of premature for me to tell certain people that they need to do certain things and stuff if you hadn't gotten to that particular level. Yeah, exactly. And it's on one level. But see, I'm explaining that because I have a basic understanding of the type of thing. It's just like when I was talking to Melchizedek, I said, "You a damn woman, ain't you?" And he said, "I like you. You got it." You see what I'm saying? But it's a whole other concept. You see what I'm saying? But I knew what was going down. I said, you're a woman, ain't you? I could have said, you a man, too, and he would have probably said, yeah, too. But the concept of the spiritual, he said, I like you. So it's a certain amount of knowledge and understanding, I would say. I wouldn't say do a certain amount of things if you didn't have a certain amount of knowledge and understanding. And I will say that much. There is certain amount of bypass and certain amount of things based on knowledge, wisdom, and understanding. But I do know I have been a practitioner of everything in the book. I have tried it. I have tried everything in the world, and one night I went through all of them. And I tell you to God, all the stuff, and the same crackers up in New York, they did the same thing, and they burnt down the house, and they exploded. Off the same deities. Crackers say, oh, I did that, man, and we got people that caught on fire up in here. Dealing with. I said, well, they ain't did nothing, but then again, on the other hand, it depends on what level we on. What level we on. This sister here, then you, what's that? Yeah. Yeah. That's good. You know, we get a group of them that come out and all, and some of them are able to stay, but they end up not being able to sell as much. Mm-hmm. It's like Paris. He was a disaster in the financial thing because he was talking good stuff. KRS-One was one of the best ones that did what he did and was able to get away with it for a short time, but even he don't sell now. But like Public Enemy, past the second album, they had to really buck dance and throw Professor Griff to the dogs and stuff just to sell one more album after that that didn't do that good. You see what I'm saying? So they virtually sold out big time. You see what I'm saying? And all, sold out big time and all. Well, Wrestle Development, they said the one thing about, you know, they were good and all, but their thing wasn't so much buck dance with the white man as it was ego problem. They said the brother's speech was, got the big head on the second album, and so he had internal strife with the actual band members after having to leave and all that kind of thing, too, also, too. And that's one thing about the ego also, so that's one thing that happened. It was more so of ego problems also, too, and all. And so some of them and all, but see, now, that can't happen with a lot of rap because, see, back when Public Enemy and X-Clan, their stuff, the rapping style is you can turn on the record and actually hear what they're saying. But now with Goody Mob and all them there, you can't see the rap style now. You can't understand what nobody's saying no way. It's in such a chaotic art form, which is a chaos, which is this now, which is a form, which is, it's looking like this now, which is a form of the cosmos. It's in such a chaotic art form until now the white man came depicted because it's gone to that particular level. It's actually another language. It's literally another language. You see what I'm saying? And Outcast and that whole thing, what they did and all. And so now, you know, and so especially with the project type language, it's a whole other realm and a whole other language now. So the white man will never be able to catch hold of this particular stuff. You see what I'm saying? Well, like Parrish would say, the devil made me do it. He showed a white man. So it was another style of rap that they could come in. So now it's transformed. It's just now, but it's transformed now until it's a limited amount of groups. So now you got to get to the point where it becomes another fashion until you get enough groups doing it. You see what I'm saying? Enough groups doing it. But even your guy, what's his name? The guy that's producing Biggie Smalls is saying their next album, they're not going to do so much of Champagne and all this kind of stuff.